Most the middle of the 18th century involved more of a group where you face, you might be in pairs, but you kind of face into a circle, and the waltz was quite different in the way that you were just with your partner and you were basically moving around the room not in a set pattern. So of course it spread all across Europe and it made its way into the ballet music of Tchaikovsky and into opera and over to the Americas where it was has made its way into all sorts of genres of music here, from musical theater to country music to various folk types. So, but we're going to play a waltz by Tchaikovsky that is not from a ballet, but it very well could be. This is from his string serenade, a wonderful four movement work, and it just is just a smooth ballet-like, beautiful Tchaikovsky waltz. So hope you enjoy. I will say that at any point during this program, we're going to be getting up and moving. We have a wonderful ballroom dance couple here that I'll introduce after a couple more selections, but we'll say there are snacks on the table that I would love to see them all get eaten, so feel free to get up and grab one at your, as you desire to. So here's some Tchaikovsky.
Thank you.
warming up here with a, we're going to go to a completely different genre of dance music now. Tango music is extraordinarily popular worldwide, but it was really first evolved in Argentina and was made very popular by the composer of this next piece, Astor Piazzolla. But it really combines South American dance rhythms with Western classical kind of instrumentation and style that really came from Italy and Spain and Southern Europe. And it's a unique sound, and maybe we'll have to do a whole tango program sometime. We'll dance the tango. But we're going to enjoy this selection, Libertango. It's one of the most famous pieces by Astor Piazzolla. Piano that might fit on this program, be a little bit different, and the great Jewish music tradition, Ashkenazi Jews, and it's a music that evolved over many centuries. But what we really think of as modern classical music today is something that's really came to the United States as part of during the mass migration at the end of the 19th century, beginning of the 20th century. And some of these styles of klezmer music that the Jewish musicians brought kind of blended with what was then emerging as American jazz. And it created this sound that was rather unique and kind of what to us today really sounds like klezmer music. And over the 20th century, this music has had a couple different revivals, and there are actually quite a few bands out there today that mix contemporary and traditional klezmer styles into their music, and you can find it all over the place. But this is celebratory music. It's typically performed at weddings and birthdays and events like that, and we're thrilled to be playing. Features Hannah Berlin. So here we go. Pleasure. demonstrate the waltz on our next number, and then give a little tutorial, and then on the following number, we'll get everyone else going. So, I am, pardon me reading, but I love your bio, so read it. So, Rick and Sarah, born in Chicago, and been married for 30 years. Rick is in the Air Force, retired from the Air Force, joined in 1988, where they ended up in Jacksonville. But they began their dance journey in 2006 at the Fred Astaire Dance Studio in North Little Rock, becoming proficient in the foxtrot, the waltz, American tango, East Coast swing, West Coast swing, hustle, bolero, cha-cha, salsa, and rumba. They were introduced to the Argentine tango in 2010. In 2014, they started competing, and in 2016, they won the Dancing Into Dreamland dance competition in Little Rock. And in 2017, were invited back to give an exhibition performance as returning champions. They've taught at Bono County Cotillion, the Little Rock Bach Club, Ballroom, Latin and Swing Club, Arkansas Arts Center, Tango at the Cabot Public Library, University of Central Arkansas, and with the Arkansas Symphony Orchestra. And they have they've developed a ballroom dancing for married couples class that is featured in several places around Arkansas. So they currently live in Cabot, and we're thrilled to have them here tonight. Please welcome Rick and Sarah today. So we're going to play by Richard Rodgers from the Rodgers scene in Rodgers and Hammerstein collection. This is the Carousel Waltz, which is actually the overture to their second musical and maybe their most popular Carousel. So hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
But first, Rick and Sarah are going to teach us a little bit about how to dance so we can all get up into it.
Before we begin, let me just tell you a little something. 13 years ago, I didn't know how to dance at all. I had zero experience. My wife took me to the Pleasure's dance studio, and she tricked me into learning. And we took one lesson there. And the instructors there were saying, did you have a good time? And we said, yes, we had a really good time. Would you like to take more lessons? And my wife was like, please, let's take more lessons. So I said, fine, let's take some more lessons. And we did, so we took some more, and we took some more. 3 years later, we started expanding. But it all started with that very first lesson. So tonight, if you've never danced before, we're going to give you that opportunity to take that very first lesson in the waltz. So at this time, if you would care to learn how to just, we're just going to do just a couple of minutes, some very short steps, some movements. I highly encourage you to come on out to the dance floor. We'll practice a little bit. They'll play the Emperor Waltz, and then we'll have some fun. So
there's three kinds of waltz. Yeah. And what you saw us do was a tango.
You encouraged me to come out. I'll tell you. Yes, she's right. There are three kinds of waltz. There's an American ballroom waltz. There's also a Viennese waltz, which is something you would see like in The King and I, something to that effect. What we just did was called the tango waltz, which is actually pronounced tango waltz, B-A-L-Z. Well, what we're going to teach right now is a little bit of American tango with maybe a little mix of Viennese. I'm sorry, American ballroom waltz with a little Viennese waltz. So, come on out to the floor. We'll just spend a couple of minutes.
We're going to hide over here.
Oh.
So if there are ladies and gentlemen here together that might want to just get up and try.
I will say this as well. If it wasn't cool, I wouldn't do it. Because again, 13 years ago, I had no desire, zero desire. But here we are 13 years later, we're doing it. So we're going to go ahead and get started. The waltz, I just said that there were three kinds of waltzes out there. All three have one thing in common. It is that traditional 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. So we're going to go ahead and just spend a couple of minutes just going over that. So what I should do is go ahead and get into a dance position. There you go. Very good. It's a traditional dance position. And what we're going to do is we're gonna just march in place. We're gonna go start. Men always start with the left foot on one. Ladies always start with the right foot on one.
You know why ladies always start with the right foot?
So we're gonna go 1-2-3. Partner going forward. Just
many, many spaghetti westerns and really develop the sound of the cinematic orchestra in a way that few others, in a league with few others. He's still adding in his 80s. He won an Oscar for score just two or three years ago. But this is a particularly beautiful score, I think, and so we're going to play the theme from Cinema Paradiso. Featuring Sam. Choreographs this, and we have three members of the Hendrix Dance Ensemble joining us today to perform this with us. So let's welcome them to the stage. as it goes on, this is like that for Waltz, there may be opportunities for you all to get back up at the end of this as well. So we'll just see how it goes.
Thank you.